Hi everyone, in this video we're going to be talking about a way of handling and working with errors in Python. The method we're going to explore in this video is called try and accept blocks. These kind of work like our previously talked about if, else, and elif statements. Here, the try and accept blocks of code are a way of handling and working around errors. So, we could say if this gives an error, print this. If this does not work, try this other thing. So, the best way to cover this topic is through an example. So let's do that. Let's ask our user for their age. Well, as it usually goes, our user found a way to break our program, and they did so by entering a string instead of an integer. The problem here is that our code is simply halted, and any code after that section is ignored. We can use the try and accept block to get around this complication. Otherwise, any trivial error within our program can cause the whole program to collapse. And as you can imagine, that wouldn't be ideal. So, we add try, colon, to our initial statement, meaning Python will try the nested code here. Then, we can add in an accept term. This means try the following statement, accept, meaning that there was an error present, then it will try the nested code. And as you can see here, although we are feeding our program the exact same information, the error no longer breaks our program, and the 1 is still printed, whereas previously it wasn't. So, it stands to reason that try accept blocks in Python are incredibly important. So what else can we do with them? Well, we can use these accept blocks of code to anticipate potential errors from our users, meaning we can assign certain outputs based on the specific error that a user has caused. So, if we go into our try section here and try to print a simple statement and forget our quotation marks around the strings, for example, we will receive a name error, since this variable is not defined. Now, when we add in our try and accept blocks, we can see that we receive a name error back out as this is the exception that was triggered. Well, what about other potential errors? Well, we can just add another exception block. Just note that you can only have multiple accept blocks when you name them a specific error, like this. So let's call this one a general exception and tell that to our user. We want the more specific errors to be identified first in our nested code, as the general accept blocks will catch all the errors that the specific exception blocks would too. So, when we run this program again, we can see that the name error is caught and identified, but the program still continues to run. If we wanted to test that the other exception block worked, we could add a math error, like so, and as you can see, we get a general error now. Now that we have an idea of how try and accept blocks work, and can be used to handle errors in Python, what else can we do with them? Well, if we want to test something, ensuring there's no errors, then continue on, we just need to add an else block. So, if our nested code in the try block didn't present any errors, so if our user entered the information correctly in this first example, then we pass right by the exception blocks because they weren't needed, and Python will continue to execute the information in this else block here. So, for example, let's print back to the user their age as it was entered correctly. And as you can see, there are no errors presented. Lastly, we have one last block to go over, and that is the finally block. The nested code here will be activated whether there is an error presented to the user or not. So, to prove that, let's add a statement saying have a good day to our user. Now, let's initiate a name error by giving Python a string instead of an integer. And as you can see here, we get our error and then the nested code from the finally block, but not the else block. Fixing this error, we see that we do get the nested bit of code in the finally block either way. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of how we can use try and accept blocks to better understand and handle errors within our Python codes. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.